let's continue with the international cooperation. The international cooperation strategy of the SNSF is to provide an optimal framework for international cooperation for researchers. And the goals are to facilitate researchers' mobility, to foster institutional cooperation within Switzerland, but also beyond Swiss boundaries, and to lower the barriers for cross-border cooperation. There is really the concentration on the added value of international cooperation, and the SNSF tries also to stay close to the needs of the researchers. And as the whole SNSF, there is a focus on scientific excellence. There is collaboration with foreign funding agencies and also foreign governments within the international cooperation. And there is a complementarity between with other Swiss actors like the leading houses of the institutions and universities. So here you have an overview over the possibilities of international collaboration within SNSF. As you have already heard before, there is the possibility to have project partners for the project funding, but for instance also for Synergia. And these project partners can get up to 20% of the total project budget, and they can be abroad. So this is the possibility also to start or to strengthen international collaboration. Then there are the mobility grants within project funding and SNF-funded projects. You will hear about that more in detail later on. As I explained before, for Synergia it is possible to have one applicant abroad if there are three or four applicants in total. And as explained at the beginning, within the career funds, there are the mobility fellowships like the DOC mobility and the postdoc mobility grants. For international networking, there are the scientific exchanges. I will go more into detail on that in a few minutes. And there are the international, global, and European programs. For instance, also the bilateral programs. Here on this world map, you see current and past collaboration opportunities on a global scale. These are also Russia, Japan, Korea, China, India, South Africa, Argentina, and Brazil are bilateral programs of the Swiss Confederation, and they are aimed to strengthen scientific cooperation with non-European countries with a high potential in the scientific research. It is the Swiss Confederation that defines with which countries Switzerland will collaborate, and when this is set up, the Swiss Confederation mandates the SNSF to organize the calls. Normally, these bilateral programs are really restricted on some specific issues and themes, and normally these are themes or research topics that are important for both countries that are involved in the bilateral program. There is a joint evaluation procedure with normally at the side of the SNSF with ad hoc panels, and typically the duration of the project is 3 and in the future 4 years. So currently, or there has been a call with Japan for the 14th of November, and next year there will be another call with Japan in the field of the sciences, natural sciences. For all the other bilateral programs, there is no concrete or specific call open or planned for next year. There might be new calls, so please go to the SNSF website and read the SNSF newsletter. I have to say that I will refer a few times to the website and also the newsletter. This does not mean that you may not call us or write us emails directly. We are always happy to ask your questions. Perhaps you see Southeast Asia, this was a multilateral call, but it's not clear if there will be other calls. And with PIER, there was the possibility to collaborate with the US. There should be new calls, but in 2 to 4 years, so you may already imagine. I will refer you to the newsletter and to the website for more detailed information. There are also possibilities for cooperation within Europe. The first one is the money follows cooperation line. This is, in this specific case, limited to the humanities. There is a bilateral joint research with Great Britain. So if you submit a project in Division 1, you might have up to 30% of the total budget that will be carried out of the research in Great Britain, and the SNSF will also finance the British part of the project. The same is reciprocally true for British researchers that submit a proposal with up to 30% contribution, Swiss contribution, and the British founder or agency will fund the whole project. Unfortunately, we have not yet finished, so you have to be a little bit more patient. The lead agency has already been mentioned within project funding, so there is the possibility to collaborate with an applicant in Austria, Belgium, France, Luxembourg, or in a slightly different manner also Germany. And there is a joint research question and a joint research plan. The parts in Switzerland and abroad are complementary and interdependent. And there are the same requirements for lead agency as also in project funding. And lead agency, as we already said, is part of the one person, two grant rule. The lead agency normally is the agency of the bigger project part that will do the evaluation. And then the other funding agency will accept the decision taken and will fund their part of the project. There might also be that it is one time it's one agency, the other time it's the other agency. This might also be the case. For more detailed information, please go also to the website of the three divisions, Division 1, 2, and 3, or call or write us. Then there is the enlargement contribution. Switzerland wants to enhance scientific collaboration with the most recent members of the European Union. There have been bilateral funding schemes with Bulgaria and Romania already. There is an open call with Croatia. The deadline is the 19th of January 2018, and it is a thematically open call, so all disciplines may apply for this Croatia call. And finally, I would like to mention cost, the cost actions and cost research project. COST is a Europe-wide scientific collaboration and cooperation between nationally financed research activities. So there are cost actions that are managed in Brussels by the European Union. A cost action can be set up if there are at least members of 7 different countries of the European Union that want to cooperate. And for a cost action, you can participate with your project that is already financed. If you would like to participate with a project that is not yet financed, you may also submit a cost research project. There are annual calls at the SNSF. There has been a call now in 2017. It is not yet clear when the next call will be in 2018. And again, the website and the newsletter will give you more detailed information.